This is Sheila. It's 2013, March. No, April now. Beginning of April. It's a sunny day here, but I'm going taking us back to October 2007. I did an awful lot of family tree research around about that time, and I had my camper van. And I made a decision to go down to Cornwall to look for some of Zara's ancestors down there, the Barbaries. More than likely originated from the Barbary pirates, a strong possibility. Anyway, Mom, I'm going to make my way down to St. Austell, where I'm going to stay in a campsite with my camper van and then wander around a place called Pentuan, a little Cornish smuggling port. Right then, here we go.
Right, it's the 2nd of October 2007. And I've made a spontaneous decision, although it had been one of the things to do, to go to Cornwall to find Zara's Barbary ancestors. So that's what I'm going to do now. I've been to Tesco's, I've been to the dentist. I need to have a fill-in next week. I just gone and got some supplies, which will come in handy anyway for when I go to Cambridge, which is another, which I can't do yet. I'll have to find me a mobile, but later on. Something on is there. Well, if anyone knows I'm going, because I'm picking Daisy up Friday. Daisy's coming to stay for a night, maybe 2 nights, because she's not too stressed out. I took them to the fair the other day, Georgia, Harry, the two girls, Amber and Daisy, Bridgewater Fair. We took them there and they loved it on the rides and that. I got myself a new computer, a brand new computer, one of those Vista ones, Windows Vista. Zara's busy setting that up and I had to get a new printer to go with it because it's all got to be compatible. I thought I'd give Zara a couple more days so she can fiddle around with it. And I'm going to find the Barberies. I haven't booked anywhere to stay yet, but because it's October now, I might not be too busy, and it's midweek. When I'm further down there, I'll stop and look at the map to see exactly where I'm going. I'm going towards Mevagissey and Pentuan. To go down there rather than Plymouth. I might go the bottom in Moor route. So when I get to Exeter, I might go that way. Yeah, I think I'll go the bottom in. I won't go. I'll go down towards Plymouth. Go through Plymouth maybe. When I get to Bodmin, because I've got to come back over the other side of the country. It ain't that far though, Bodmin. Bodmin. No, it ain't far from Mevagissey actually. St. Austell. Don't think. Can't find it, I haven't got my glasses on. Anyway, I'll do that in a minute. Service stations to have a wee. I should have had a wee. It's one of these important things. I know we don't want to talk about it really, but it is one of those basic things that you've got to think about. off on the spur of the moment. As part of the expedition, and I got loads of tinned food, got some bread rolls, some flour, a little pack of flour, coffee, tea, milk, water, toilet roll, bananas, bit of fruit, and drinks and cake. Just going to fill up the petrol, so I'll just finish this bag. I'll have to change the tyre when I... Well, hopefully I won't have to change the tyre before I get down there, but there is one that might just last that journey. Before it's illegal, it won't blow, I don't think. Anyway, I've got my sleeping bag, got my hook up, and I'm escaping again. While I got the chance. I'll speak to you later. The time is 25 past 10, and the miles on the clock are 109728. This is the Cornwall Run. We're just leaving Tesco's car park in Weston. Folks, we're going down to Cornwall where the chicken song was made. And I might sing that on the way down there. Right, that was £30 worth of petrol, which is just over halfway, so three quarters full tank. Right, that was straightforward. I've got to Pentuan, or Pentuan, however you pronounce it. I've got myself booked into a caravan site, which is huge. The pitch I've got is absolutely huge. So that's pretty good. Called Golden Valley or something like that. I can't remember now. So I've got a big pitch. It's got luxury showers in it. You can have all these jets sprayed at you. It plays music. It's got a swimming pool there, which you've got use of. It's in the lovely grounds. It's in the grounds of a mansion. There's luxury apartments in the mansion, apparently. And I've actually parked up in right in the heart of the village of Pentuan, or Pentuan. Pentuan, I don't know how you pronounce it. And it's free car parking. So I'm going to have a wander around now and have a look for the Barbary cottage. Bye. Right. Looking off of the car park, there's Pentuan Cycle Hire. There's River Walks. There's West End Street. I don't know where the Barbary cottage will be, but I'll have a look. There's Ocean Sports, where you can hire body boards, diving equipment, wetsuits, cycles, fishing gear. You can go for diving courses. And there's Higher West End Street, the old post office. I'll take a picture of that. Place called Dolphin Cottage. Oh, and the Ship Inn pub as well. It's a cosy cottage. It's pretty old. Oh, and a place called the Customs House next door to Sunny Cottage. And a pump right in the middle of the square. The Pisky Cove is like a shop with a restaurant as well. Some quite big buildings as well. Primrose Cottage. Right, I just spoke to somebody who said that some Barbary cottages up here somewhere on North Road. But the Barbarys don't actually live in the village anymore, mainly Mevigacy. But they own seven of the cottages up here on the right, up North Road, and they rent them out. So I'm walking along this little pathway, Willow Brook. North Road is called Barbary Cottage, but apparently you've got one or two up here. say that on into my tape, will you?
Pentuan.
Pentuan. Right. Right, she's just been telling me about a smuggler's passage behind the cottages. That's not sort of so functional, but obviously people don't smuggle now. And this is the old inn in North Road as well. So anyway, behind these little row of cottages, which are original, there used to be like a little channel or alley. And they said that was like for smuggling. So Barbary links pretty good from that point of view. There is a public bridle path. I don't know where it goes, but I'd have to probably do that another time. I'm at the end now. It's a cul-de-sac at the end here. There's a whole row of these little mariners' cottages. Yeah, I suppose there must be, God, I don't know, 10, 15 of them. Little terrace cottages. They're the originals, and that's where Zara's ancestors, probably in North Street. I'll have it on the censuses as well. Now owned by the Barbarys of Mevagissey. A bomb landed in the war in North Street, believe it or not, and destroyed the old church. That's now been turned into a bungalow. And there is a new church. A young girl who rents one of the cottages actually told me about that. You know, the one bomb and it landed on the church in North Road. Or North Street. I can't remember if it's North Street or North Road now. So that's pretty good. Weather's nice, not raining. This little tiny road where the cottages are is on a hill, and there's a little stream, and I can hear it bubbling away in the background. And then further down, as you look down the hill, there's sort of another hill over the other side of the cove. I'm going to make my way to the cove in a minute. Apparently there aren't any gravestones or anything in this area, but most people will be in the Mevagissey or St. Austell, and apparently it's a really nice place there, the girl was telling me. Two of them are doing up number 20 and I suppose number 19, so skip outside one. Of course only a couple doors up was the old pub as well. Walking up this very steep hill to find the coastal path and the new church that was built possibly after the old one was destroyed. It's a place called the Terrace, and the church at Pentuan is All Saints Church. And leading to the coastal footpath. Right, I've been to the church, and I'm not quite sure where I'm going now. I think I'm following the coastal path, I don't know. It's sort of built on a sort of Methodist type looking place. I'll just go up a bit higher up the path for a minute. I'm climbing up the coastal path to get a view of the bay. It's a good job it isn't raining now. Climbing up the path. The old bay of Pentuan. They had to be fit in them days if they used to have to smuggle flipping treasure. Not these hills, bloody hell. There's an absolutely massive camper caravan site. Obviously there's some tourists because there's hookups. And it backs right down onto the beach. So that's one way of getting Zara down here if we wanted to get a caravan. you still have the van to wander off, she'd be able to wander about. Right, I'm at the sort of harbour, I think, now. Some big old metal chains and old walls and old places. Yeah, this bit's known as the harbour. Yeah. Yeah, you can see the old remnants of past. People used to use this harbour, and now the old lock gates are decaying and rotting. It's like a little porchway I'm going under now, covered in ivy. Yeah, it's quite a small place. They filled in, looks like it's filled in the where the water used to come up to the docks to let boats in once. That's all sort of overgrown, and whether they'd ever reclaim it, I don't know. But it is a small place. Probably hasn't changed a great deal, but there I did see a notice on the public notice board of plans for redevelopment. The only sad thing is that, in a way, is that huge caravan site. You know, it does look really horrible, really. There's even old railway lines here, so the railway used to come all the way down here as well. Remnants of the old quay. Right, I've been down to the harbour and onto the beach. I'm just going up North Road again to where the cottages are, to see if I can find out any more information. G car Beth. Oh right, June Barbary. Yeah. Okay, because we've got people who live in Wells as well who come from the Barbary line down here as well. Right, that was interesting. I went back to I think it was number 16 and spoke to a lady whose maiden name was Eden. And the cottage next door to her with Barbary written on it is actually rented out as a holiday home, and it's available all year round, and she's given me the name of the Barbary that own it. So that's interesting. And she's lived along that road for all her life, and so has her family. I think she said another name was Radcliffe. In fact, her father, I think, was born and lived in the old inn along there, which was a pub, a couple doors up. And his family before him lived there as well. So that's interesting. Real local people. I should have got them on tape, really. Right, that was really good. Really good visit to Pentuan. And I should have got that woman on tape, really. But still, you can't even feel embarrassed. It's like a breach of confidentiality, isn't it, really? Well, I'm not going back to the caravan site yet. There's still hours of light left. Remember, Gissy's only just up the road. So I'm going to go and have a wander there. And I'm going to probably eat out there as well. Have a pasty or something. Should have gone to the toilet again. Right, the number for the Barberies is 0162 68 63, or it could be a 3 or 5, 175. I think it's 6863175. And that's June Barbary. Her husband is G. Carbeth, C-A-R-B-E-T-H. And there's three sisters, I believe, Barbary sisters. Some live at Newton Abbott, and one lives at, not Weymouth, I can't remember the name, something Warren, anyway. And the woman I spoke to a minute ago was Margaret Meehan, Meehan, and she used to be, I can't remember, I'll put it on tape anyway, her maiden name. I got that further back on the tape. So that's hers. So it might be worth phoning in at some point.
Okay, part two of Pentuan visit in 2007, to be continued shortly on another recording. Lots more to come, folks. Over and out. This is Sheila in 2024.